Welcome all of you. This is your 16th lecture in the series of online lectures and you are learning Economic Standard 12th of Maharashtra Board, HSC Board. Welcome to my class. As you are learning economics and currently we are learning lesson number 4, that is elasticity of demand. Okay, actually see, this is the sub part of demand itself. What you have learnt in earlier lesson, that was demand analysis. Okay, and this is the sub part of demand analysis, that is elasticity of demand. Though it is fourth, but it is the part of demand analysis itself. So the lesson number is 3B. Okay, so currently you are learning lesson number 3B, that is elasticity of demand. And what did we learn in our last lecture? In our last lecture, we had completed introduction, concept of elasticity of demand and different types of elasticity of demand, which were given on page number 27 to 28 of lesson number 3B, that is elasticity of demand. And now, what we are going to see today, what we are going to learn today, that is lesson number 3B, elasticity of demand, and we are going to learn different types of price elasticity of demand, okay, which are given on page number 28 to 30. See, this is the special lecture in which we are going to learn types of price elasticity of demand in detail. One, this question can be asked for 8 marks. See this, and many sub questions can also be asked on this topic, that is types of price elasticity of demand, as well as it can be asked also for objective question. Okay, so we are going to learn this topic in detail. Now let's see. See, this is as per the press note which has been released by Maharashtra Board from lesson number 3B. Okay, this from these pages, page number 27, 28, 33 and 34, column number 2, 1, 1 and 2 respectively, this syllabus has been declared as self study. Okay, as per the 25% reduction in the syllabus for this academic year only. Okay, so as and when we come across that page number, I will let you know. Okay, what syllabus has been declared as self-study syllabus. Now, let's move to the elasticity of demand. As we have already completed what is meant by elasticity of demand in our first lecture, okay, but then also we will take a quick review of it. In the previous chapter, you have already studied the law of demand, which shows the inverse relationship between quantity demanded and price of a commodity. See, what we had learned? When the price was increasing, the quantity demanded was decreasing. Okay, that was what? That was the law of demand. Okay, so what it shows? It shows the inverse relationship. See, the direction of price is increasing, then the direction of quantity is decreasing. There is an inverse relationship. If the price is decreasing, then the quantity demanded increases. Okay, so this is what? This is again the law of demand. So, what it shows, there is the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded, that we have already seen in our last lesson, that is demand analysis. But the law of demand does not explain the extent, okay, the extent of change in the demand due to changes in the price. What it fails, see, the law of demand fails to extend the extent. What is meant by extent? Extent means degree or the measure or the quantity of change in demand due to the quantity of change in the price. Okay, it has some limitations. What it explains? Only with the increase in the price, quantity demanded decreases, or with the decrease in the price, quantity demanded increases. That only was explained in the law of demand. Okay, so it has some limitations. So the law of demand fails to explain the quantitative relationship between price and quantity demanded. Where it failed? Explain the quantitative relationship. How much of changes would be there in the quantity demanded, at what extent, at what degree, with the whatever degree of changes in the price. Okay, see, so for that Professor Alfred Marshall explained the concept of elasticity of demand. Okay, so the elasticity of demand is the solution for the drawbacks which were there in the law of demand. Okay, so for that we are going to learn elasticity of demand. And elasticity of demand has many uses. See, elasticity indicates what is meant by elasticity? Responsiveness or sensitivity of one variable to another. Okay, this is the general meaning of elasticity. It is the stretchiness. See how much can something can be stretched. It is the stretchiness or stretchability, or we can call it as in simple words flexibility. Flexibility of one variable with reference to the flexibility of the other variable. Okay, that is learnt under elasticity. But we are learning economics. So okay, we are learning economics in micro view. Okay, see, so what is meant by micro view? Microscopic view. And we are learning consumer behavior, which learns the economic behavior of individual units, that is demand. Demand for individual goods by consumer, a single consumer and his demand for individual goods. That we are learning, that is meant by economic behavior of individual. That is called as consumer behavior. And consumer behavior is learned under microeconomics. Okay. So, demand or demand analysis, or elasticity of demand, these are the factors of demand, those are learnt under microeconomics. So we are learning this lesson, elasticity of demand under microeconomics. See, what is meant by elasticity? First of all, see, for example, the item, what is this item? Stone. Can stone be stretched? Can stone be flexible? Can this piece of wood or log be stretched, or is it flexible? Is it responsive to anything, any variable? No, because those are static. See, this stone, this wood are static. Those cannot be stretched, or those are not responsive to any of the other variable. But whereas if you think about this rubber, okay, or this spring or rubber are flexible. They can be stretched. These commodities are very responsive to the other factor. Which is the other factor? See, for example, this rubber is stretched with the fingers. Okay, see, what was the earlier size of this rubber? This much, if we consider. And after stretching, it gets bigger. Okay, or even if we compress some spring, that spring gets compressed also, right? See, this is here. Which force has been applied to this spring? The force of hands. Okay, if the other, what is the other variable? The force of hands. Okay, if the force has been applied by the hands to the spring, it gets compressed. And if it is stretched by the hands, what is the variable again here? Hands. If it is stretched by the hands, it gets flexible. Okay, it gets stretched. These are the characteristics of rubber or spring. What is this characteristic? This is the elasticity. Okay, see, this rubber can be stretched. So it is elastic. So what we are going to learn? Elasticity of demand. Okay, demand is also elastic. Okay, demand can also be stretched. It can be flexible. It is responsive. To which variable? Two different variables we learned. Okay, which two variables? See, demand is responsive with three variables. Which was the first variable we learned? Income. Okay, the demand was responsive with income of the consumer. What was the second variable? Cross elasticity. The demand of one variable was dependent upon the demand of its substitute variable. Okay, substitute commodity. That also we have already learned in our last lecture, in our earlier lecture. And today we are going to learn elasticity of demand with price. Okay, what is concept of elasticity of demand? The term elasticity indicates responsiveness of one variable to a change in the other variable. That we saw that rubber is one of the variable which can be stretched with the other variable. That is the action of if it's stretched by taking in the fingers. Okay, see, so elasticity of demand refers to the degree of responsiveness. Now what we are going to learn, how much it can be stretched with the other forces. Okay, what is the degree of responsiveness of quantity demanded to a change in its price or other factor. Okay, how much of quantity demanded is responsive or flexible with respect to the flexibility in the other factors, that we are going to learn under elasticity of demand. Okay, see, a measure of how much buyers respond to change in the market conditions, that is a measure of the responsiveness of quantity demanded to one of its determinants. Which determinants we are going to see? Price, income, and other determinants, determinant, that is substitute goods or. Okay, so this is what we are going to learn under elasticity of demand. Okay. Elasticity is an economic concept that measures the responsiveness of one variable to changes in other variable. The variables in this question are price and income with quantity demanded. Okay. See, price affects the quantity demanded as well as income of the consumer affects the quantity demanded. Okay. Elasticity explains how much one variable, which variable, for example, quantity demanded, how much quantity demanded will change in response to the other variable, which is the other variable, like the price of the product or the income of the consumer or complementary and substitute goods. Okay. So with these variables, how much of the quantity demanded varies, okay, with reference to these three variables. But now, see, this is the concept of elasticity of demand. As we have already studied, elasticity of demand with reference to two variables, that is income and complementary and substitute good. But in today's lecture, we are going to see elasticity of demand with reference to price only. Okay, see, if this is the balance, okay, or weighing scale, then how the other factor, other weighing scale affects or is responsive with the changes in the price. See, if the price changes of the commodity, then the demand for the commodity may vary. Okay, it may increase or it may also decrease. If the price, then how much it will decrease and how much it will increase with the increase in the price or decrease in the price of the commodity, that we are going to learn under price elasticity of demand. Okay. According to Professor Arfield Marshall, elasticity of demand is great or small according to the amount demanded. See, it depends upon the amount demanded, which rises much or little for a given fall in price, and quantity demanded falls much or little for a given rise in the price. Means how much of quantity demanded increases with reference to the how much of the fall in the price. Okay, or how much of quantity demanded decreases with the how much of the increase in the price, that we are going to learn under price elasticity of demand. Okay, now it is clear from the above definition that elasticity of demand is a technical term which describes the responsiveness of change in quantity demanded to fall or rise in its price. In other words, it is the ratio of what it is, it is the ratio of what percentage change in quantity demanded of a commodity to a percentage change in its price. Okay, how much of change in the quantity demanded will occur with a percentage change in its price, that we are going to learn under price elasticity of demand. See, there are three types of elasticity of demand: income elasticity, cross elasticity, and price elasticity. Out of that, we have already completed these two types of elasticity in our earlier lecture. See, but now we are going to learn the third type of elasticity, that is price elasticity. When we are learning price elasticity, other factors, which are the other factors? Income of the consumer, complementary goods, substituted goods, those are considered to be fixed. Okay, we are not going to consider all these three factors. Okay, so all these three factors are not considered while we are learning price elasticity. Those are considered to be unchanged. Okay, those are considered to be fixed. But what we are going to learn only price. See, with the price, if you are thinking of the price of the commodity, how much of the demand of the commodity will change? Okay, that only we are going to learn under price elasticity. See, according to Professor Arfield Marshall, price elasticity of demand is a ratio. What it is? It is a ratio of proportionate change in the quantity demanded of a commodity to a given proportionate change in its price. Okay, proportionate. Okay, proportionate means we have to refer to the same change in the price. Okay, if you are going to consider the change in demand, then we have to consider the same change in demand in its price at the same time. That is what is proportionate change. Okay, ratio. What is meant by ratio? It is what we are called. Ratio means relationship. Okay, in simple words, we can call it as a relationship. We are going to consider or examine the relationship of what it is proportionate change in the quantity demanded to a proportionate change in its price. Okay, that is called as price elasticity. And what is the formula for price elasticity? That is elasticity of demand. It is percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. Why divided by? Because we are going to learn the ratio. Okay, see, it is the ratio, it is the formula, okay, to calculate the elasticity of demand with reference to price. Okay, now see, if you think about the price elasticity, what is the formula? What did I say? Percentage change, see, percentage change in quantity demanded with reference to percentage change in its price. Okay, so what is this? How can we simplify this in formula? What is the formula? See, percentage change in quantity demanded. See, change in quantity demanded. What is meant by change in quantity demanded? What was the earlier quantity demanded and what is the new quantity demanded? That is called a change in quantity demanded. For example, earlier quantity demanded was 50 and new quantity demanded is 60. Then what is the change in quantity demanded? 10. Okay, so what is 10? That is change in quantity demanded. What is change in quantity demanded? 10. And what was the earlier quantity? 50. Okay, so if we simplify this, percentage change in quantity demanded, it is change in quantity demanded divided by original quantity. Okay, and if we simplify this, percentage change in price. Okay, similarly, what is meant by percentage change in price? The new price, that is change in price divided by earlier price. Okay, change in price divided by earlier price. Now if we think about the earlier price was rupees 200. Okay, and the now current price is rupees 150. So what is the change in price? 50 rupees. Okay, so what is the change in price? 50 divided by what was the earlier price? 200. Okay, so change in price is the new, what was the change? Okay, and change in quantity means what was the change in the quantity demanded. Okay, so this we have simplified like this, and this denominator we have simplified like this. Now as per this formula, now what is, if this part, change in quantity, percentage change in price, how we have written? Change in price divided by original price. Now this P, this entire part, entire denominator, if you think about, then what we can do, this is denominator, so this P will get multiplied with the rule of cross multiplication. Okay, because it is divided by this numerator. Okay, so this will go upward and P will come upward, and this change in price will come again the denominator of this P. Okay, with the rule of cross elasticity. So what is the final formula of elasticity of demand? It is per change in quantity divided by original quantity into price, original price divided by change in price. Okay, see, Q is what? Q is the original quantity demanded. Delta Q is what? Difference between the new quantity and original demand, original quantity demanded. Okay, this is the difference. Okay, we have to only think the difference between the new quantity demanded and original quantity demanded. If the original quantity demanded is 50 and new quantity demanded is 60, then what we have to take? Only the difference. Okay, difference. What is the difference? 10. Okay, we have to take the difference between the new quantity and original quantity demanded. See, original price, if the original price was rupees 200, then we have to take it as it is, and difference between new price and original price. Okay, see, what was the, if the price became 150, then what is the difference? 50 rupees. Okay, the price decreased by 50 rupees. Okay, then we have to take only the difference between the new price and original price. Okay, see, in this way we can calculate the price elasticity of demand. See, according to law of demand, the demand for goods and services changes when there is change in its price. But the relationship between demand and price may not be equal. See, it cannot be equal and same in all the cases. See, the change in demand with respect to change in price cannot be same and cannot be equal in all the cases. It may vary from product to product, from time to time, and from vary from market to market also. So as to understand the extent or the degree or the measure or quantity of the effect of price on the demand, okay, we have to understand or to learn the extent or degree of the effect of price on the demand. It is required to understand the different types of price elasticity of demand. Okay, how much of the there would be the responsiveness of the quantity demanded, at what quantity, at what degree, with what change in its price, how much of change in its price, that is learnt under different types of price elasticity of demand. Okay, see, the price elasticity of demand is a very important concept under economics because it is useful for taking the different economic, important economic decisions by the producers, by the firm, by the marketing agencies. Okay, so it is an important concept. Okay, now see, with what is what we are going to learn. See, with the change in the price, okay, of the commodity, how much is the change in its quantity demanded, that we are going to learn under price elasticity of demand and its different types. See, there are different types of price elasticity of demand. First is perfectly elastic demand, okay, and it is as elasticity of demand is equal to infinite. Second type is perfectly inelastic demand, that is elasticity of demand is equal to zero. Third is unitary elastic demand, elasticity of demand is equal to one. Fourth is relatively elastic demand, elasticity of demand is greater than one. And fifth is relatively inelastic demand, that is elasticity of demand is less than one. Okay, now what is this? See, there are five types. Okay, these are the different five types of elasticity of demand. Okay, but now if you think, these are the different, what varies actually, what is the difference? See, in this, in the first type, what is said, elastic demand, the demand is very elastic. How much it is elastic? It is perfectly elastic. In this first type, the demand is perfectly elastic, means what is varying, the demand is 100% varying. Okay, the demand is 100% perfectly elastic. Then what would be constant? It means the price is constant. If the demand is perfectly elastic, going to be elastic, then it means price is constant. And in this case, elasticity of demand is infinite. Okay, because demand is 100% elastic. Okay, nevertheless of the price, then it means the demand is perfectly elastic. Demand is going to be infinite. Second is perfectly inelastic demand. What does this mean? Demand is fixed, it is stable, it is not listening to anyone. Okay, it is remaining constant. Okay, it is not at all flexible, it is not at all responsive, it is not at all stretchy. Okay, it means demand is inelastic, it is perfectly inelastic, it is not listening to anyone. Okay, this is means perfectly inelastic demand. If demand is remaining to be 100% inelastic, okay, it is remaining to be static, then what must be changing? In this case, price must be changing. Okay, the price is changing, that time demand is remaining inelastic. Okay, and that is called as elasticity of demand is zero, because demand, what we are learning, demand. Okay, we are not going to think about the price, we are learning elasticity of demand. If demand is going to be static, inelastic, then elasticity of demand is zero. Then is unitary elastic demand. What is meant by unitary? Same. With the same amount of change in the price, same amount of change in the demand. Okay, that is called as elasticity of demand is equal to 1. Then relatively elastic demand. What is meant by relatively? We can call it comparatively, it is elastic. Okay, comparatively it is elastic. Then with the elasticity in the, with the change in the price. Okay, means when we think the change in the price is lesser, but compared to it, means relative to price, demand is more. Okay, that is called as elasticity of demand is more than one. Next is relatively inelastic demand. Demand is going to be static compared to the change in the demand in change in the price. It means relatively inelastic. Means comparatively, the demand is going to be inelastic with reference to the change in the price. Okay, that is the fifth type. That is elasticity of demand is less than one. Okay, if you understand this concept, okay, clearly, then it is very easy for you to understand the five different types of elasticity of price. Elasticity of demand with reference to price elasticity. See, economics for decision makers, it is useful for price elasticity of demand. Okay, it is very useful for understanding the price elasticity of demand. Okay, with the increasing the price, demand decreases, or with the decreasing the price, demand increases. See, there are types of price elasticity of demand. First is perfectly elastic demand. Okay, I have already just explained what to remember. Perfectly elastic demand is elastic. And how much it is elastic? Perfectly elastic. Okay, now see, when a slight or zero change in the price, see how much is the change in the price? Slight change or zero change in the price brings about an infinite change in the quantity demanded. See, quantity demanded is infinite with reference to zero. There cannot it can be the state when there is no change in the price or a slight change in the price. Then what happens? The quantity demanded is infinite. There is a change in the quantity demanded at infinite extent. It is called as perfectly elastic demand. It is only a theoretical concept. In reality, it doesn't happen. For example, 10% fall in price may lead to an infinite rise in the demand. Okay, there are very few realistic examples for this. Okay, see, what is the formula for elasticity of demand? Percentage change in quantity demanded divided by a percentage change in price, and the answer is infinite for what? Perfectly elastic demand. See, as there is no change in price, see, what? See, price changes, price, there is no change in the price. Price remains same or a slight change. Okay, so what is, as there is no change in the price, denominator in this formula is zero. Okay, because there is no change in the price. As the denominator is zero, so the elasticity will be infinite. Okay, as per Mass rule, if the any solution, the if the denominator is zero, then the answer is infinite. Okay, see, if we look at this graph, okay, what it is shown over here, see, this is the price. How much is the price? OP is the price. See, on the x-axis, quantity demanded has been shown, and on the y-axis, price has been shown. See, the price is remaining the same. Then, the quantity demanded, suppose we think if the quantity demanded Q, it is remaining the same. If it is this much, for example, if we say 10, then even though the price is remaining the same, the quantity demanded increases and becomes 2-1. Okay, if the price is still remaining same, quantity demanded increases and becomes Q2. Okay, price is still remaining the same, quantity demanded is increasing and becoming Q3. Okay, see, the price is remaining same from OP, but the quantity demanded is changing from OQ to OQ1, OQ2, OQ3. Okay, see, this is infinite change in the demand, quantity demanded. Okay, but the price is remaining same. So what it we call it as, this is the infinite, see, this is the perfectly elastic demand. Demand is perfectly elastic. Okay, it is going on changing, increasing. That is called as perfectly elastic demand. Okay, but when the even if the price is remaining same, the quantity demanded is increasing. See, in figure 3.11, the demand curve, if we join these points, okay, if we join these points, what we get? We get a curve. Okay, this, what is this curve? This is a horizontal line parallel to x-axis. Okay, if we join these points, we get a horizontal line parallel to x-axis. What it is? The demand curve is a horizontal line parallel to x-axis, indicating perfectly elastic demand. Okay, see, this is the extreme case. In reality, there can be very few or less examples if we are going to explain the perfect elastic demand. Okay, see, but if it, just to take as the example, if we find many cab services available in metropolitan cities, see, there are many cab services available in metropolitan cities, and even any of the cab services decreases their rate, their travel rate, just 1 rupee per kilometer, then there can be seen extreme demand, increase in extreme demand for that specific cab service. Okay, or any of the cab services increases their rate per kilometer just by 1 rupee, then we can find there is extreme decrease in the demand for that specific cab service. Okay, so this is the one of the example we can just take. Okay, the another example of, see, even if the price of the gold remains constant or same, then also we can find there is extreme in demand for the gold. Okay, even if the price remains same, there is an extreme in demand for the gold. The another example can be taken of electricity. See, there are many power generators, and if we are consuming the power from a specific power generator company, and if you are finding that there is increase in the bill, and if we come to know that the other power generator company has decreased their rate, consumption rate per unit, then consumers will go for the other consumer, the demand for that specific power generator company will decrease. Okay, and vice versa. So there are few realistic examples, okay, which can be seen with perfectly elastic demand. Okay, because demand is infinite. See, the second type of price elasticity demand is inelastic. Okay, demand is inelastic, demand is perfectly inelastic, means demand is remaining static, constant. Okay, now see, when a percentage change in price has no effect on the quantity demanded, okay, it has no effect, it is remaining inelastic, static, of a commodity, it is called as perfectly inelastic demand. For example, 20% fall in price will have no effect on quantity demanded. Okay, if there is fall in price by 20%, the quantity demand will have no effect. This also, in practice, such a situation rarely occurs. Okay, for this also, there is this condition rarely occurs. For example, demand for salt means necessity goods, demand for milk. Okay, what happens? Even if the price rise or the price falls, the demand remains same for the salt or milk. Okay, see, what's the formula for elasticity demand? Percentage change in quantity demanded by percent divided by percentage change in price. Okay, see, what is the percentage change in quantity demanded? It is zero. Okay, percentage change in quantity demanded is remaining same with respect to the percentage change in price. Even if it increases by 20 rupees or 20%, there is no comparatively change in the demand. Okay, demand remains same even though the price increases. Okay, so as the numerator is zero, this is perfectly inelastic demand is zero, because we are learning demand. Okay, we are learning the changes in demand, because we are learning demand analysis or elasticity of demand. The demand remains same, there is no change of demand with respect to the change in the price. Okay, as the numerator is zero, in perfectly inelastic demand, the answer is zero. See, what is this? See, if this is the price P, then the quantity demanded when the price was P was D. Okay, the price was D. Okay, now what was the equilibrium point? This is the equilibrium point when the price was D. Now if the price increases, see, if the price increases and becomes P1, okay, if the price increases and becomes P1, then also what happens? If the price is P1, then also the quantity demanded remains same. Okay, the equilibrium point is this one. Even if the price decreases and becomes price P2, then also quantity demanded is same. Okay, means there is no flexibility, there is no responsiveness of the quantity demanded with the change in the price. Okay, so what is this? The price, the quantity demanded is remaining inelastic. Okay, it is not flexible, it is not responsive, it is not stretchy. Okay, see, if we join these equilibrium points, then we'll get a straight line, vertical line, which is parallel to y-axis. See, this vertical line is parallel to y-axis. In which case, when it is perfectly inelastic demand. See, in figure 3.12, when price rises from OP, see, earlier it was OP, it rises from OP or OP1, from OP to OP1. When price falls from OP to OP2, whatever it be, demand remains unchanged at OQ. See, always the demand is OQ, whether the price is OP1, OP or OP2. Okay, the demand remains same. Therefore, the demand curve is a vertical straight line. See, it is a vertical straight line. We can find this, which is parallel to y-axis, right? Which is parallel to, this vertical line is parallel to y-axis, which is indicating perfectly inelastic demand. Demand is fixed. Okay. See, what can the examples for this? Milk bag, milk pouch, the demand for milk, the demand for salt, which remains same. Whether the price increases or decreases. Okay, why? The demand is inelastic because these are the necessity goods. The third type of demand is unitary elastic demand. Okay, unitary elastic. When a percentage change in price, see, listen properly, percentage change in price leads to proportionate change in quantity demanded. Okay, there is proportionate change, which is the same quantity, proportionate. With the percentage change in price, proportionate, same quantity of change in the quantity demanded. Then demand is said to be unitary elastic. Okay, unitary, same. Demand is same elastic. For example, 50% fall in price of a commodity leads to 50% rise in quantity demanded. See, what is the fall in price? 50%. And what is the increase in quantity demanded? 50%. Both are same. Okay, proportionate to each other. Okay, that is called as unitary elastic. Okay, then what we find, what is the formula for this? Percentage change in quantity demanded by percentage change in price. See, what is the percentage change in quantity demanded? 50. And percentage change in price? 50. So, what is the solution? What is the answer? 1. So, what is the elasticity of demand? It is 1. 1 means unitary. Okay, it is same, equal. See, proportionate change in quantity demanded and proportionate change in price are equal or in same degree or in same extent. Okay, both are same, same degree, same extent. And it gives a graph of rectangular hyperbola. What is meant by rectangular hyperbola? A hyperbola with transverse and conjugate axis equal to each other. That is also called as equiangular hyperbola or equilateral hyperbola. Okay, let's see what is meant by this. See, when there is, see, earlier price was P, which is shown on y-axis, and earlier quantity demanded was Q. Okay, so what was the equilibrium point? It was D. Okay, and price is plotted on y-axis. If the price decreased and became P1, the quantity demanded increased with the same percentage as the same as the percentage the price decreased, the quantity demanded also increased by the same percentage and it became Q1. Okay, so we got the equilibrium point as this D. Okay, and if we join this equilibrium point, we get a curve. Okay, this curve is called as rectangular hyperbola. Okay, see, this curve is called as rectangular hyperbola. In figure 3.13, when price falls from OP to OP1, see, this is 50% fall, demand rises from OQ to OQ1. Okay, that is also 50% increase. See, because this is the same, see, if you are plotted on the axis graphs, this is the same unit which is shown over here. Okay, same extent. Okay, therefore, this is the slope which we get. The slope of the demand curve is rectangular hyperbola. Okay, why it is called as rectangular hyperbola? See, what is meant by rectangular hyperbola? Rectangular hyperbola, it is a curve under which all rectangle areas are equal. See, if you calculate this rectangular area, okay, see, if you calculate this rectangular area, then it is area of this rectangular, it is the same. Okay, if we call the other rectangular area which is under that curve, okay, if we calculate this rectangular area, this is also same, okay. If we calculate the another rectangular area, okay, this is same. The area of the rectangles below this curve are same, okay, that is called as rectangular hyperbola, okay. The curve under which all rectangular areas are equal, okay, that is called as rectangular hyperbola. And then we find that elasticity of demand is 1 because it is the same. Okay, it is the same. See, now what are the realistic examples of this rectangular hyperbola, of this price elasticity of demand? See, what happens with the same increase or decrease in the price? Okay, the same increase or decrease in the quantity demanded. Okay, so this area is same and this area is also same. Whatever is under that hyperbola, whatever touches to the points of that hyperbola, and if we draw the rectangle, the area is same. Okay, if we take this point and we draw the rectangle touching to the both axes, okay, the area is same. Area of this rectangle is same. Okay, now what are the realistic example? It would be for clothing. Okay, see, as much as is the increase or decrease in the price, as much as the increase in the price, there is that much of decrease in the demand. Okay, the next type of price elasticity demand is relatively elastic. What is meant by relatively? Relatively means comparatively. Comparatively, the demand is elastic. Compared to what? Compared to price. Okay, means demand is more elastic than price. Then we call it as relative. Relative means comparatively the demand is more elastic than the change in the price. Okay, see, when a percentage change, and what is the solution of it? What is it is shown? Elasticity of demand is more than 1. Okay, when a percentage change in price, see, percentage change in price leads to more than proportionate change in quantity demanded. The demand is said to be relatively elastic, comparatively elastic. Okay, see, means percentage change in price brings more change in the quantity demanded. You can say like this, percentage change in price brings more proportionate change in quantity demanded. Then it is called as elasticity demand is comparatively or relatively more. It is called as relatively elastic, more elastic. Okay, for example, 50% fall in price. See, fall in price is 50%, but that leads to 100% rise in quantity demanded. Okay, so price fall in price is 50%, but whereas rise in quantity demand is more than the percentage price fall in price. Okay, this is called as elasticity of demand is comparatively more. Okay, see, if you take this formula, percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price is price elasticity of demand. Okay, now percentage change in quantity demanded with reference to percentage change in price. Now if the price change in price is 50 rupees but the change in demand is 100, so what we found, the numerator is bigger because change in demand is comparatively bigger with reference to change in price. Okay, so what it is, numerator is bigger, and if the numerator is bigger, the solution, the answer can be always more than 1. Okay, in this case it is 2, but what happens if the numerator is bigger than the denominator, the obviously the answer would be elasticity of demand would be more than 1. Okay, see, numerator is always greater or bigger than the denominator. For example, and in which cases this happens? With the luxury items, comfortable goods, air travel, TV, refrigerator, etc., luxury cars, luxury commodities, okay, or comfortable goods, the with the lesser decrease in price, there is comparatively more demand, okay, for these commodities, luxury commodities and comfortable goods. See, and what happens with this? See, if this is the 50, earlier price was P and earlier quantity demanded was Q, and we got this equilibrium point, that is D point. Now the price decreased from P to P1, Okay, see, this much of is the extent of the decrease in the price. Okay, this much is the extent in the decrease of the price. But what happened with this much of extent in the decrease in the price? Quantity demanded increased more than that extent. Okay, see, it is more from when it came to P1, quantity demanded became Q1. Okay, and we got this equilibrium point. Okay, so this is more. See, this distance is more with compared to the change in the price. Okay, so what is this? Quantity demanded is relatively elastic compared to the change in price. Okay, and if we join this curve, we got a flatter line. See what we got? A flatter line, a flatter slope. Okay, see, in figure 3.14, when price falls from P to P1, see what happened? Price fall from P to P1. That is how much is the price fall in price? 50% fall in price. But demand rises from OQ to OQ1. It became OQ1 now. That is 100% change in the demand. Therefore, the demand curve has a flatter slope. Okay, if you join these equilibrium points, we get a flatter slope. In which case, when the demand is relatively elastic, okay, it is more elastic than the change in the price. See, in which case this happens? This happens with the luxury goods or comfortable goods. See, if the change, there is decrease in the price by 50% or whatever percent, there is more change in the quantity demanded. Okay, it may be TV, refrigerator, washing machine, AC, okay, or this air travel or luxury items, luxury commodities, okay, it can be seen. Then the See, when a percentage change in price leads to less than proportionate change in the quantity demanded, for fifth type, that is relatively inelastic demand, okay, percentage change in price is less with respect to proportionate change in quantity demanded. The demand is said to be relatively inelastic. What we are thinking about? Demand. Demand is inelastic with reference to what? Change in price. Okay, or with compared to price. For example, if there is 50% fall in price, then what happens? Demand increase only to 25%. Okay, so what means? Demand remain inelastic. Okay, it didn't change much. It didn't become more flexible with the change in the price, proportionate price. That is called as relatively inelastic demand. Okay, demand was obstinate. It was not listening to the changes in the price. Okay, so we can call it demand was inelastic. See, if we take the formula, elasticity of demand for price, percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. Okay, percentage change in quantity demanded with reference to percentage change in price. If the price change by 50 units, okay, at the same time, with the proportionate change in quantity demanded was 25 units only. Okay, see, this is the denominator is more bigger compared to the numerator. So what happened? The answer is 0.5. Okay, it is lesser than 1. What is the elasticity demand of price? It is 0.5 or it is lesser than 1. Okay, see, the numerator is always smaller. In this case, numerator is always smaller number than the denominator. So, coefficient value is less than 1. What is the coefficient value? It is 0.1. Okay, whatever it may, but it is less than 1 always. Okay, because the denominator is bigger and the numerator is lesser. Numerator is always smaller. See, whatever is the answer, that answer lies between 0 to 1. Neither 0 nor 1. Because 1 is for unitary and 0 is for perfectly inelastic. Okay. But this is relatively inelastic. So, for relatively inelastic, the answer can be from 0 to 1. Neither 0 nor 1. But lies between 0 and 1. And with which of cases it happens? It happens with the necessary goods like medicines, LPG, matchbox, etc. We'll see the example. See, relatively inelastic demand. What happens? See, if the earlier price was P and the quantity demanded was Q, okay, and we got this equilibrium point D. Okay, now see the price decreased from P to P1. Now see, this much is the extent of decrease in the price. But what happened with the proportionate change in the quantity what demanded? The quantity demanded changed. It did not remain fixed or inelastic. But compared to the change in price, the change in quantity demanded was lesser. See, this is lesser with compared to this. Okay, this unit. Okay, so what we can say? The quantity demanded was lesser or smaller, or it remained comparatively or relatively inelastic with the change in the price. And we got this equilibrium point. Okay, and if we join these equilibrium points, we get a curve. And what is the tendency of this curve? See, it is steeper. Comparatively, it is steeper. Why? Because elasticity is not much for this kind, relatively inelastic demand. Okay, see, in figure 3.15, when price falls from OP, earlier was OP, to OP1, right? It fall from OP to OP1. What happened? The demand rises from OQ to OQ1. That is 25%. The increase in demand is 25% only. But whereas the decrease in price was 50%. Therefore, the demand curve has a steeper slope. If we join the points, we get a steeper slope. Okay. And what is the answer of this price elasticity, this relatively inelastic demand? It is lesser than 1. Okay. If we put it in the formula, if we put the numbers in the formula, we get the answer lesser than 1. See, what we find? We find the rapid, sharply sloping, steep demand curve. Okay. Rapid and sharply sloping steep demand curve in what? In relatively inelastic demand. Okay, see, in which cases it happens? It may be for medicines, LPG gas, or matchboxes. Why are we taking the example of matchboxes? See, even if there is increase in the price, okay, or decrease in the price, what happens? If there is too much increase in the price, then what happens? Do we buy the LPG gas cylinder very less? No, it is comparatively relatively less. Okay, and even if there is a, and if the price falls for the LPG cylinder drastically, then what happens? Do we purchase LPG cylinders much more? No. See, similarly for medicines, if the price of the medicines falls, then do we consume more medicines? No. Then the example for matchbox. See, price of matchbox is just for 2 rupees. 2 rupees we get a matchbox in which there are 5 sticks. Okay, that can be sufficient for 1 month. If the price of the matchbox falls from ₹2 to ₹1, are we going to buy the matchboxes, 100 matchboxes in a month? No. So there cannot be more or much flexible demand we can find for the matchbox. Okay, so these are relatively inelastic demands with reference to the changes in the price.
Elasticity is a measure of the responsiveness of one economic variable to a change in another. Price elasticity of demand, or PED, indicates the relationship between price and quantity demanded. Measuring PED helps a producer make more effective economic decisions. This equation is used to calculate PED. If PED equals 1, it is unitary. Less than 1 means inelastic. And greater than 1 means elastic. For example, if coffee bean prices increase from $1 a kilo to $1.20, and daily sales drop from 500 kilos to 450, PED is -10% over +20%, which gives an answer of -0.5, which is inelastic. The coffee grower can now estimate how revenue will be affected. Here, revenue increases from $500 to $540 because demand is inelastic. However, if PED is elastic at 2.0, demand would drop by 40% and revenue falls to $360. An inelastic PED means revenue increases when price increases. Elastic means revenue falls when price increases. A perfectly elastic demand curve over its length is horizontal. A perfectly inelastic one is vertical. A unitary elastic curve, where all price and quantity combinations yield identical revenue, is called a rectangular hyperbola.
Now, this is, you have understood it very well. I hope you have understood it very well. Then this is the homework for you. Identify the type of price elasticity of demand for the following goods. Okay? You have to consider these goods: cosmetics, medicines, school uniform, and air conditioners. What are the type of price elasticity we can apply to these goods that you have to find out? Okay? And you have to answer in the comment section. And the other homework for you is, complete the table. What is given in this table? Four columns has been given. In first column, there are serial numbers. In second column, there is degree of elasticity of demand. Third column, type of elasticity of demand. And in fourth column, the description of that type of demand has been given. Okay? In every row, one thing is missing. Okay? In every one row, one thing is missing. And you have to think these two units, okay, these two properties, and you have to write the answer over here. Okay, for this second row, this information has been given and this information has been given. By considering these two informations, you have to write the answer over here. Okay, see, there are total 5 cases has been given and you have to write the answer in the in this missing boxes, in this filling the blanks. Okay, so this is the homework for you. And what will we learn in our next lecture? In our next lecture, we are going to see different methods of measuring price elasticity of demand. Okay, there are different methods in which we can measure this price elasticity of demand, which is given on page number 30 to 32. Okay, with reference to lesson number 3B, elasticity of demand. And I hope you have understood this concept very well, because I have explained it in detail, in much detail. Deeply I have explained it to you, okay? And this is an important concept which if you have taken the commerce field or if you are learning the economics, this is going to be an important concept which will be helpful for all the fields, okay? So I hope that you understood it very well. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe and study online.